بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This question actually and this case it's common in Arab port, Saudi port, Jordanian port and Egyptian port. And really it will help you during your practice also. This is cardiac case. Baby is cyanosed or cyanotic newborn is suspected to have congenital heart disease. ECG done for this baby. What is the finding in the ECG? Left axis deviation with left ventricular hypertrophy. So what is the most likely diagnosis? So put on your mind, cyanosis with left axis deviation and the left ventricular hypertrophy, قولا واحدا, tricuspid atresia. Tricuspid atresia, cyanosis with left axis deviation or left ventricular hypertrophy, this is tricuspid atresia, قولا واحدا. This is the clue in these questions. Cyanosis with left axis deviation, left ventricular hypertrophy, this is tricuspid atresia. So if you will see here the choices, this is TGA is not the case, truncus arteriosus is not the case, tricuspid atresia, this is the case. Why tricuspid atresia? Cyanosis with left axis deviation and left ventricular hypertrophy, tricuspid atresia. Tetralogy of Fallot, it will be enlarged right ventricle, but here this is hypoblastic right ventricle, hypoblastic right ventricle. Persistent fetal circulation actually is not the case. So this clue in this question, cyanosis with left axis deviation, left ventricular hypertrophy, tricuspid atresia. Common questions in Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board, Egyptian board, all the boards. If you will see here, this one, this is the tricuspid atresia. What is the meaning of tricuspid atresia? This absent of the tricuspid valve, agenesis of the tricuspid valve. So no communications between the right atrium and right ventricle. So the right ventricle, it will be shrunk and underdeveloped. We call it hypoblastic right ventricle. What is the type? Sometimes it will be muscular, membranous, valvular. It would be associated with TGA, associated with pulmonary stenosis. This is all, it will be associated with this case. If you will see here, this is the clue. Cyanosis with left axis deviation, left ventricular hypertrophy, tricuspid atresia, tricuspid atresia. So tricuspid atresia have hypoblastic right ventricle, and therefore the ECG left axis deviation and left ventricular hypertrophy. Why there is left ventricular hypertrophy? Because hypoblastic right ventricle, hypoblastic right ventricle. And put in your mind, almost all other form of cyanotic heart disease, actually it will be are associated with elevated pressure in the right ventricle. So it will be therefore the ECG, it will be right axis deviation or right ventricular hypertrophy. So the old cyanotic heart disease, it will be associated with right axis deviation and right ventricular hypertrophy. But if you will see cyanosis with left axis deviation, left ventricular hypertrophy, this is tricuspid atresia. So tricuspid atresia, it will be associated with underdevelopment of the right ventricle, leading to hypoblastic right ventricle. But the other cyanotic heart disease, it will be associated with right axis deviation and right ventricular hypertrophy. Once you have cyanosis with left axis deviation and the left ventricular hypertrophy, this is tricuspid atresia, قولا واحدا. This is the clue and the common question in Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board. If we'll see here, if there is no communications, you see, no communication between the right atrium and right ventricle, because atresia, actually the tricuspid valve, absent tricuspid valve. So no communication between the right ventricle, the right atrium and right ventricle. So what are going to do for to survive your baby will need either AACD, atrial septal defect. So it will decrease the pressure in the right atrium, it will go to the left atrium. So it will be mixing, leading to mixing to keep the baby survive, or through the VSCD, or through VSCD also to keep the baby survive, and BDE also. So you have to be shunting to help the baby to survive. Either it will be ASCD or VSCD or BDE. We'll see the pathophysiology of the tricuspid valve atresia. There is atresia of the tricuspid valve. Yes, tricuspid valve atresia. What will happen? No communication between right atrium and right ventricle. What will happen for the right ventricle? It will be underdeveloped. It will be hypoblastic right ventricle, and systemic venous blood it will receive by what? Right atrium. So the right atrium, all the blood comes to right atrium. It will be pressure it very high. So it will, the blood it will push through the ASD to the left, what? Left atrium, to left atrium. So the blood would enter to the left atrium through what? BFO or ASD. Because the pressure in the right atrium, the tricuspid valve is closed. So no blood goes to the right ventricle. So all the blood in the right atrium. So it will go through what? Through the ASD or BFO to left atrium. Make it mixing so to supply the pulmonary and systemic circulation. So there is mixing, it will happen because the blood it goes through the from the right ventricle, right atrium to left atrium through the ASD. So there is mixing in the systemic and pulmonary circulation. Then the blood it goes from right atrium to left atrium, from left atrium to left ventricle, then through the VSD the blood enter to the right ventricle through the VSD, and from the right ventricle it will enter to the pulmonary trunk. So the blood it will go to the right atrium through the ASD, it goes to left atrium, then it goes to left ventricle, so it goes through the VSD to right ventricle, then it will go to the pulmonary trunk through what? The blood to pulmonary through the BDA. So the blood it will increase in the pulmonary blood flow. The pulmonary blood flow it will increase, leading to what? Leading to left atrium and left ventricle hypertrophy and congestive heart failure. So this is left atrium hypertrophy and left ventricular hypertrophy. And this is cyanosis with left axis deviation. Left ventricular hypertrophy, this is tricuspid atresia. And this is the ECG. It will be what? It will be left axis deviation here. If you will see here in the lead 2, this is left axis deviation. And if you will see here, there is left ventricular predominant and absent of the right ventricular forces. There is two types of the tricuspid atresia. Tricuspid atresia associated with TGA or pulmonary stenosis. So the clue from this question, actually, you will put in your mind cyanosis with left axis deviation, left ventricular hypertrophy. This is tricuspid atresia. And the baby cannot survive because no blood goes from the right atrium to right ventricle, and right ventricle actually it will be underdeveloped or hypoblastic right ventricle. So what will how to the baby survive? Through the ASD. So the blood it will go from the right atrium through the ASD to left atrium, from left atrium to left ventricle through the VSD, it will go to the right ventricle, and from right ventricle to go to pulmonary trunk through the BDA. It will increase the mixing and the pulmonary circulation, so it will increase the left atrium and the left ventricular hypertrophy, leading to congestive heart failure. And in the ECG, it will leading to left axis deviation, left ventricular hypertrophy. So baby with cyanosis, left axis deviation and the left ventricular hypertrophy, this is tricuspid atresia. This is the message from this question, actually. Cyanosis with left axis deviation, left ventricular hypertrophy, tricuspid atresia. Because all the cyanotic heart disease, it will be associated with right axis deviation and right ventricular hypertrophy. It is the opposite it's happen, this is tricuspid atresia. It will be associated with hypoblastic right ventricle. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام عليكم.